Welcome to our channel, Lakshmi Forever. This is Lakshmi connecting with you with one more healthy millet recipe, pearl millet recipe, pearl millet dosa and pearl millet idli. This is called as kambu in Tamil and in Hindi we call it bajra. You should be very familiar with the word bajra. This really looks like a pearl. As this word pearl itself implies, it is a pearl-like precious millet, no doubt. This millet is packed with all goodies. You have to really understand how much more is packed within this little pearl millet. You have proteins, you have water, you have ash, you have carbohydrates, you have omega-3, you have omega-6 fatty acids, and then you have vitamin E, vitamin K, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, vitamin B6, folate, pantothenic acid, calcium, iron, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, zinc, copper, manganese, selenium. This list goes on. Such good millet. So tough to find, right? Totally. That is why this millet ranks on top of all the millet family. 55% of people who are wanting to try a millet first lay their hands only on pearl millet. Easy to process and so much of benefits. It gels so well. You can make a pearl millet chapati. You can make pearl millet dosa. You can make pearl millet idli. It is everywhere. And you always also make a pearl millet porridge. And you also make kambanguru, they call it. It is like, you know, it is again another kind of a porridge which is served cool with the curd. So with all these wonderful magical ingredients packed in such a small pearl millet, I'm sure we all understand that plenty of nutritional and health benefits are coming, you know, to us from nature, Mother Nature. And there are, you know, many reasons that you should not avoid pearl millet in our regular dietary habits. It is very powerful in controlling diabetes, makes us feel full, and you know, you don't feel hungry very soon. So totally controls type 2 diabetes, and then it is very good for weight loss program. So most of your nutritionists will are sure to advise you to take pearl millet as part of your dietary schedule, and it reduces cholesterol. It has got all the good fatty acids, omega-3, omega-6, and it helps in digestion for all your sore mouth and sore stomach, you know, sores in your mouth and stomach. This is totally very good because riboflavin is packed within this millet. So naturally, it heals your mouth sores and your ulcer problems, and it also prevents cancer. It has got such protecting properties, and pearl millet is very good for your bone growth. It is very good for a glowing skin. It helps you avoid constipation, totally takes care of your heart care. Vitamin B3, which is very, very essential for your heart care, is already packed and ready in your pearl millet. And beta carotene, which is reason for generating vitamin A, happens to be readily available in pearl millet. So friends, so there is absolutely no reason for us to avoid this pearl millet from our kitchen. And now after this demonstration, you will very well understand that usage of this pearl millet is no big rocket science. It is as simple and as easy as our regular cooking. And it is just that we'll have to get familiarized with the usage. And when once you look at it, you're going to include it in your regular kitchen routine. And please do give this kambu dosa and kambu idli, we call it in Tamil. Please give this pearl millet dosa and idli as frequently for the children also in the family. With such nutrition available readily, I'm sure we should ensure healthy and happy nutrition for our family. Now let's get on to the recipe.
For pearl millet idli and dosa, I have taken 3 measures of pearl millet, washed it cleanly, and then soaked it for 3 hours. And I'm now going to grind it in the mixie. And together with this 3 measures of pearl millet, I have also soaked 1 measure of raw rice. You can also, replace it with little millet. Who wants to avoid raw rice can also make use of little millet in place of raw rice. And we can grind both this together in the mixie jar. And I have also soaked 3/4 measure of urad dal, added with 1 teaspoonful of Bengal gram dal and half a teaspoon of fenugreek. With all this, I have also soaked another 3/4 cup of beaten rice. So we call it avil in Tamil. We grind all this and we grind the dal separately with beaten rice and this pearl millet separately, and mix both this. And we can I have ground it totally in a mixer grinder and added enough salt to taste and have allowed it to ferment for the next 6 hours. Now the batter is ready to make dosa. And when it is nicely fermented, you can also try the same batter to make idlis. You will get super soft idlis and crispy dosas out of the same batter. What more you want? An idli and dosa, you can make chutneys, different types of chutneys. You can also make idli podis. You can make chutney powders. All that will go very well with your pearl millet dosa and idli. Your regular sambars or your regular kurmas or your veg gravies or non-veg gravies, anything goes well and very well with pearl millet dosa and idli. Thank you so much. Please do try and leave your comments. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. And also do not forget to press the bell button. With the bell button, you get our notifications and you can see our videos immediately. And leave your comments and give us all your support. I'll connect with you very soon with another interesting topic. Till then, signing off, Lakshmi forever.